morning to all of you. Once again, a warm welcome to the Computer Networks online session. Today, video number 29, which also belongs to the unit number 4. Mostly, this is the last part of unit number 4. I hope you guys all know the unit number 4 is the medium access control sublayer, that is MAC sublayer. So which is the part of data link layer. As we already discussed that, so data link layer consisting of two parts. The lower part is the MAC, which connecting to the physical layer, and the upper part is LLC, logical link control, which is connecting to the network layer. So as usual, before going to start this session, just to recall what we discussed in the past sessions. So these are the topics we covered up to right now. Those are the channel allocation problems with the static channel allocation assumption for dynamic channel allocation and multiple access protocols. There we discussed the very important concepts in this unit, that is Aloha and CSMA, carrier sense multiple access. And then we discussed the Ethernet topic. So there in the Ethernet, we discussed 10 base, 100 base and 1000 base Ethernet cables. So there in the physical layer, the physical connection establishment will be done by using any one of these cables that may be a twisted pair cable or coaxial cable or fiber optical cable, different type of cables we have to be using to connect to the physical layer. So after connecting to the physical layer, the data has to be accessed in the form of raw bits. That's what we discussed in the physical layer mostly. So the data has to be accessed in the form of raw bits. These raw bits are first moving to the data link layer. So here the data link layer design issues are there. Total 4 design issues are there for data link layer. Those are it provides services to the network layer, and framing, error control, flow control, along with that error detection, error correction. There are some services provided by the data link layer. So here the data link layer is divided into two parts. The upper part is LLC, logical link control, and the lower part is MAC, medium access control. Upper part is LLC, logical link control, and the lower part is MAC, medium access control. So there, the data link layer is subdivided into two parts. The upper part is LLC, logical link control, and the lower part is MAC, medium access control. So there up to we discussed these topics, the channel allocation problems, the static channel allocation in LANs and MANs, and dynamic channel allocation in LANs and MANs. But here, multiple users are using the same channel. So that is multiple access. For that purpose, we discussed multiple access protocols. These multiple access protocols are using if multiple users are accessing same path. So what are the different problems? That means collisions occurred. For that purpose, we discussed the protocols like Aloha and CSMA. So in Aloha, we covered pure Aloha, slotted Aloha. So these are the throughputs of pure Aloha and slotted Aloha. So to overcome the problems occurred in pure Aloha, slotted Aloha is discovered. So, but the throughput of slotted Aloha is only 36.8. For that purpose, they implemented another protocol called carrier sense multiple access CSMA. There are different persistent techniques are there. One persistent, N persistent, and P persistent methods we discussed. One persistent, non-persistent, and P persistent. Later we discussed some wireless protocols, right? And next, in the last video, we covered this Ethernet concept. So how the Ethernet cabling are there? So there are three versions are there in the Ethernet cabling. That is 10 base, 100 base, and 1000 base. So 10 base means the types of 10 Mbps Ethernets. 100 base means 100 Mbps Ethernets, and 1000 base means 1000 Mbps Ethernets. So there are 4 categories in the 10 base. Those are 10 base 5 cables, 10 base 2 cables, 10 base T cables, and 10 base F cables. So 10 base 5 are the thick coaxial cable, 10 base 2 are the thin coaxial cable, and 10 base T is the twisted pair cable, and 10 base F is the fiber optical cable. And here the segment range, how many nodes it has to be divided, and the topologies, what is used for these cables, that what we discussed in the past video. So this one is the Ethernet cabling technique, 10 base 5, 10 base 2, and 10 base 3. next Ethernet MAC sublayer protocols, that what we covered. Ethernet performance, these one very important one, switched Ethernet and fast Ethernet. So fast Ethernet means 100 base. So the normal Ethernet we discussed is 10 base cables. Here the fast Ethernet is the 100 base cables. So 100 base T4, 100 base TX, and 100 base FX. There are the three types of fast Ethernet cables are there. For that purpose, for 10 base T4 twisted pair cables are using. For 10 base TX twisted pair cables we are using. For 10 base FX fiber optical cables are using. These are the segment ranging of cabling. And next one is the gigabit Ethernet. So fast Ethernet consisting of 100 Mbps, but the gigabit Ethernet consisting of 1000 Mbps. For that purpose, here the name is 1000 base SX, 1000 base LX, 1000 base CX, and 1000 base T. If you observe that in the normal Ethernet 10 base, there are 4 category cables. In the fast Ethernet, that means 100 base, there are three types. In the gigabit Ethernet, that is 1000 base, again there are 4 categories are there. And the cables here we are using is fiber optical cables for 1000 base SX, fiber optical cable for 1000 base LX, and 2 pair of HTP for 1000 base CX, and 4 pairs of UTP for 1000 base T cables, right? That part we covered is LLC, data link layer consisting, subdivided into two parts, LLC and MAC. MAC connected to physical layer and LLC connected to network layer. The position of LLC is this one, and the protocol formats is this one. So now, today's concept that is wireless LANs. So here, in this video, we covered the 802.11 protocol stack, the 802.11 physical layer, and the 802.11 MAC sublayer protocols, and the 802.11 frame structure, and the different services provided by the 802.11. So all these are called it as the wireless LANs. So why? Because up to now we covered the Ethernet cables, 10 base, 100 base, 1000 base, all are the physically presented cables. The Ethernet cables are the physically connected cables. So the protocols what we have to be discussed are the wireless LANs, so 802.11, right? So the physical layer has to be accessing the data in two ways. One may be wired connection, second one is wireless connection. For wired connection purpose, in guided transmission media, we are using different cables, twisted pair cables, coaxial cables, and fiber optical cables. So many type of cables we are preferred to access data. That means access data in the form of rabbits to the physical layer. And the second way of accessing data is wireless. So the connection has to be established in two ways. One is wired connection, second one is wireless connection. For wired connection, we are using so many cables, that what we discussed up to right now. So what are the different advantages of 10 base cables? What are the different advantages of 100 base cables? What are the different advantages of 1000 base cables? And now we are moving to wireless LANs. So the first we will start with 802.11 protocol stack. This is the 802.11 protocol stack. As usual, this is the data link layer, and this one is the physical layer. Data link layer and physical layer. So again, the data link layer is converted into two parts. One is MAC, medium access control sublayer, and the upper part is logical link control, LLC. So the LLC connecting to the upper part of data link layer, and the MAC is connecting to the lower part of data link layer. So the lower part of data link layer connected to physical layer, and the upper part of data link layer connected to network layer. So I think, I hope you guys all understood why, because that what we discussed there in the OSI reference model. It consisting of 7 layers. The starting layer is physical, next data link, thereafter network, thereafter transport. That what we discussed so many times about this layered architecture. Like that, here in the data link layer, it is divided into two parts, LLC, logical link control, and MAC, medium access control. So the MAC is connected to physical layer, and LLC, logical link control, is connected to the upper network layer. Now again in physical layer, so here so many wireless technologies we preferred, so many wireless protocols we are using. Those are 802.11 infrared. 802.11 infrared is one of the wireless protocol, and 802.11 FHSS, and 802.11 DSS, and 802.11A FDM, and 802.11B HR DSS, and 802.11g OFDM. These are all the wireless protocol stack in the physical layer. So the physical layer accessing data in two ways. One by using wired connection and one by using wireless connection. Any one of these connections, either wired connection or wireless connection, the basic responsibility of physical layer is it has to be connected and access the raw bit of data. So these raw bits are moving to data link layer. That means via moving to the MAC layer, there the services what we have to be discussed. So it provides the design issues of data link layer. It provides services to the network layer, framing, error control, and the flow control will done by the data link layer. So these data is moving to the network layer, and again same vice versa, the data link layer accessing data packets from the network layer and moving those data packets to the network layer in the receiver end, moving the particular data packets to the network layer at the receiver end. So this is the 802.11 protocol stack. So upper layers, data link layer, physical layer. So again the data link layer LLC and MAC. In physical layer, 802.11 infrared, 802.11 FHSS, 802.11 DSS, 802.11 FDM, 802.11 HRDSS, and 802.11 OFDM. So this is the part of the 802.11 protocol stack. This is the part of 802.11 protocol stack. The 802.11 MAC sublayer protocol is, here there are two type of problems are there. Those are, one is hidden station problem. Second one is the exposed station problem. The first one is the hidden station problem, and the second one is the exposed station problem, right? What happened here is, for example, there are three stations are there, A, B, C. There are three stations are there, A, B, C. B in the range of A. So B is in the range of A. And again, B is in the range of C. B is in the range of C. So B both in the range of A and C. But A not in the range of C and C not in the range of A. So please observe clearly. There are three stations are there, station A, station B, and station C. So station B is the between layer of A and C. So B in the range of A and B in the range of C. B in the range of A as well as B in the range of C. But C not in the range of A, A not in the range of C. So A doesn't know about C, C doesn't know about A. So here A and C are called it as the hidden terminals. So here A and C are called it as the hidden terminals. Here A wants to send data packet to B, and again C also wants to send data packet to the B. So A wants to send data frame to the B, C also wants to send data frame to B, but A doesn't know about C and C doesn't know about A. So first A transmits the data frame. Why? Because A feels I am only the station connecting to B. That's why A sends the data frame. C again also feels like that. C also feels that I am also the only one station connecting to B. C also sends the data frame to the B. In between, a collision may be occurred. Why? Because at a time A's frame and B's frame is reached to the B station, there a collision may be occurred. So here A and C are called it as the hidden terminals. This problem is called hidden station problem. So A is the hidden terminal to C and C is the hidden terminal to A. So that is the hidden station problem. And the second problem is the exposed station problem. Exposed station problem is, so as usual, A in the range of B and C in the range of B. And again, another station is there, that is D. So D in the range of C. So B wants to transmit data to A. And again wants to transmit data to D. First B sends a data frame to A, but A is busy here, but B waits for some amount of time. So what happened here is, actually B also wants data frame to D also. So there D is empty. So D is the another path and A is the another path. If A is busy, immediately if B sends data frame to D, it is right path. But what happened here is B is wait until A is released. B is wait until A is released. It will take so many time. Why? Because if B wants to send data packet to D, D is empty. If B sends data packet to D, there is no problem. But B waits for A's release. That is the problem here. This is called exposed station problem. Here the D is the exposed terminal. So I hope you guys understand. So what happened there in exposed terminal is, in this example, A, B, C are there. A and B in same range. So B wants to send data frame to A, but A is busy. If B also wants to send data frame to C, if A is busy, if B immediately start transmitted data frame to C, there is no problem. But B waits until A is released. So that is the problem here. The most of the time is wasted here. So that is the exposed terminal problem. So in hidden terminal problem, collision, hidden station problem, collision will be occurred. In exposed terminal problem, so much time is delayed. So that is the two problems here. In 802.11 MAC sublayer protocol, there are two problems. One is hidden station problem. Second one is exposed station problem. In hidden station problem, collision will be occurred. At exposed station problem, time delay will be happened. For that reason, in 802.11 MAC sublayer protocols, here we are using two frames. Those are RTS and CTS frames. Request transfer frames and acknowledgement frames. So request frame and acknowledgement frame. RTS is the request frame and CTS is the acknowledgement frame. So how we have to solve the hidden terminal problem is, if A wants to send data packet to B, it sends first a request frame, RTS. If B is empty, B sends CTS frames. If A receives CTS frames, then A starts transmitting data packet. In the same way, if C wants to send data frame to B, C sends RTS frames. But B doesn't send the CTS frame to C. Why? Because already a transmission is running between A and B. So C is waiting until receiving of CTS frame from B. When it receives CTS frames, whenever the B is empty, then B sends the CTS frame to C. That is the use of virtual channel sensing using CSMA/CA. Carrier sends multiple access with collision avoidance. How the collision is avoiding here is by using RTS and CTS frames. And the next one is the same 802.11 MAC sublayer protocol. RTS frame, fragments, fragment burst, CTS frames, acknowledgement. RTS means request frame, CTS is the acknowledgement frame. So here this is the fragment burst. So inter frame spacing in 802.11. First one is SIFS, BAFS, DAFS, TAFS. Control frame or next fragment may be seen here. Here the control frame or next fragment may be sent here. The PCS frames may be sent here. The DCS frames may be sent here. And the bad frame recovery done here. This is the time period and this one is the acknowledgement. This one is the inter-frame spacing. Control frame, PCS frame, DCS frame and bad frame recovered here. These are DCS frames sent, PCS frames sent and control frames are next generation may be sent here. This one is the very important one, the 802.11 frame structure. So this is 802.11 frame structure. The four checksum, data, address 4, sequence, address 3, address 2, address 1. Duration and frame control. Again in the frame control, the bits are version, type, subtype, 2, DS and from DS, MF, retry, PWR, more, W0. These are the frame control. For the better understanding of these frame control, you go through with the lecture notes. You can easily understand what is meant by DS and MF and what happened, how the frame is structured. Right, this is the 802.11 data frame. And these are the services provided by the 802.11. 802.11 services. The first one are the distribution services. The distribution services are association, deassociation, reassociation, distribution, and integration. These are the different services provided by the 802.11 association, deassociation, reassociation, distribution, and integration. These five are the distribution services. And intra-cell services are, again, it provides some intra-cell services. Those are authentication, de-authentication, privacy, and data delivery. I think you guys know about the what is meant by privacy, how the data delivery is done, and how it done authentication, de-authentication, and what is meant by association, de-association, re-association, distribution, and integration. The complete explanation that I'm given there in the lecture notes. So you go through with that for better understanding of these services. So that distribution services are association, de-association, re-association, distribution, integration, and the intra-cell services are authentication, de-authentication, privacy, and data delivery. And the final summary, this one is the final summary. The first method is FDM. It dedicates a frequency band to each station. The FDM, which dedicates a frequency band to each station. And wavelength division and dynamic FDM scheme for fiber cable. And TDM, time division, dedicated a time slot to each station. And pure Aloha, unsynchronized transmission at any instant. Slotted Aloha, random transmission in well-defined time slots. And one persistent CSMA, standards carrier sends multiple access, and non-persistence, random delay, P persistence, CSMA, but with a probability of P of persisting, and CSMA CD, abort on detecting a collision, and bitmap, binary countdown, tree walk, MAC A and MAC W, and Ethernet, FHSS, and DSSS, that is direct sequence spread spectrum, and frequency hopping spread spectrum, and collision avoidance. CSMA series is the collision avoidance techniques. These are the different techniques what we have to be using in the frame delivery in the data link layer. With this, we successfully completed the second part of the data link layer. So that is unit number 4 is completed with this. So both unit number 3 and unit number 4 belongs to the data link layer. From the next unit, we started with the network layer. So I will make another 2 videos for overview of this unit number 4. So what we covered in this video is 802.11 wireless LANs. So protocol stack, physical layer, and different services provided by the 802.11.